learned a unit called as mathematical tools, right? Yes or no? In mathematical tools, we have learned all the tools like functions, trigonometry, vector, and finally we learned two important tools from calculus. The first one was derivative and the second one integration. Okay. Now we will be using integration also here, but initially we will use derivative. Now when we have defined derivative, you turn few pages back and check the definition of derivative, what is written. If y is equal to f of x, then delta y by delta x gives average change in y, with respect to x between two points. Yes or no? Are you understanding? So you substitute x is equal to x1, you will get some value of y, that is y1. You substitute x is equal to x2, you will get some value y2. Now you find out y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. This quantity, whatever you will find out, is called as average change in y with respect to x. But at particular value of x, only x1, if I want to find out, how y is changing with respect to x, then that is given by dy by dx. So dy by dx, that is derivative of y with respect to x, gives rate of change of y, with respect to x at specific value of x. Yes or no? Value of x. Same principle we will be using to define instantaneous velocity and average velocity. Now you understood why we learn derivative? Yes or no? Why we learn derivative? Why we struggled so much to grasp a totally new mathematical process? Because we had to use it here. Now in class 9, the case for you was from here to Kankavli, distance is, let us say, 50 kilometer. It is not 50, but let us say 50 kilometer. You took 1 hour. So what was your average speed, or what was your average velocity, provided you are moving in a straight line? 50 kilometer per hour. Now I am not interested in what is average velocity between Kudal to Kankavli. You tell me what is your velocity when you were crossing Oras. Are you understanding? So at particular value of x, now I am interested to find out what is average velocity value, and that is called as instantaneous velocity. So it all starts with representing position of a particle as a function of time. So first thing you have to understand is representing position of particle, which is moving in a straight line, okay, or which is in motion, particle with or as a function of time, So now this Kudal, Kankavli, etc., etc., will go off and they will say x is a function of time. For example, x is equal to 3x square, 3t square plus 2t. X is what? Function of time. So position of your particle which is traveling is function of only one parameter. What is that? Time. So you substitute time t is equal to 0 second, you will get x is equal to 0. So you are starting from 0. You substitute t is equal to 5 second, you will get some value of x. What is that? 25 into 3, 75 plus 10, 85. Okay, 85 meter, let's say. So x is equal to 85 meter when t is equal to 5 second. So here onward, they will be always giving you position of a particle as function of time. Okay, position of a particle as function of time. So the, this is the general equation for position as function of time. Function of time. Now if this is the scenario, then how we will find out average velocity? If I want to find out average velocity, I should know I need 2 points, 1 and 2. Okay, so always remember average velocity is calibrated between two time intervals, t1 and t2. When I will substitute t is equal to t1, I will get some value of x, that will be x1. When I will substitute t is equal to t2, I will get some value of x, let us say that is x2. And if you know x1, x2, t1, t2, then how you will find out average velocity? V average is equal to x2 minus x1 divided by t2 minus t1, because we know it is delta x by delta t. This is the definition of average velocity now for us. Because we are grown up, we are not in class 9 to say only displacement by time is average velocity. That is also basic definition, correct? But this is more accurate definition. Average velocity is always, we find it out between two points t1 and t2. So delta x by delta t gives us average velocity. Right? Now, let's go to the second point which is of our interest, because this is what we know already. Second point of our interest is, what is instantaneous velocity? If x is equal to f of t, position is function of time. Generally, how we call velocity? Rate of change of displacement is velocity. And how we find out rate of change? If it is between two points, delta x by delta t. If it is at one point, dx by dt. Yes or no? So if x is function of time, dx by dt will give you rate of change of x with respect to t. Yes or no? This is the expression for instantaneous velocity. So instantaneous velocity will be dx by dt, whereas average velocity will be delta x by delta t. Now this will be the general expression. Then based on t is equal to t1, you can find out what is instantaneous velocity at t1. You can find out what is instantaneous velocity at t2, t3, t4, whatever point you want to find out, you can do that. Okay, you can do that. For example, I have taken one function here. What was that? 3t square plus 2t. This is f of t. And they are asking you, what is instantaneous velocity of this object? This is x. X is equal to f of t. So I know dx by dt is equal to how much? 6t plus 2. By now you should know this, right? You know how to differentiate, yes or no? Okay, so this is the general expression for instantaneous velocity. Now my question is, give me what is instantaneous velocity when t is equal to 2 seconds. Then what will be your answer? 6 into 2 plus 2, 14 meter per second. Are you understanding? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so please write down this average velocity and instantaneous velocity. Then we will write the basic definition and also we will solve a problem. So if I'll ask you to define what is average velocity, what you will say? rate of change of position of a particle with respect to time between two time intervals t1 and t2. Are you understanding? T1 and t2. And if I'll ask you to define instantaneous velocity, rate of change of position with respect to time at a single time interval t. Understood or not? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So if x is f of t, what is dx by dt? What is dx by dt? Instantaneous velocity. If x is f of t, what is dx by dt? Instantaneous velocity. So if x is given, you take derivative, you will get dx by dt, which is instantaneous velocity. So if dx by dt is given and if you want to find out x, what you will do? Integrating dx by dt, you will get x. Now you understood why we learned integration? Because if position is given as function of time, you can find out velocity by taking derivative. But if already they give you velocity as a function of time, then you can integrate that and get position. Understood or not? Okay. Now, NCERT. Let us solve a question given from NCERT. Write it down. The position of an object moving along. Shall I rub this? Shall I clean the board? You write it down. The position of an object moving along x-axis, position of an object moving along x-axis is given by x is equal to a plus bt square. So here what they have given, x is function of time, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. X is equal to a plus bt square, full stop. Where a is equal to 8.5 meter. A is 8.5 meter, so it's a constant. And b is equal to 2.5 meter per second square. And t is measured in seconds. Okay. Then they are asking, what is its velocity at? T is equal to 0 second. What is its velocity at t is equal to 0 seconds? And t is equal to 2 seconds. So what velocity they are asking? At t is equal to 0 and at t is equal to 2. Which velocity? Instantaneous velocity, is it? Full stop. What is the average velocity between? T is equal to 2 seconds and t is equal to 4 seconds. They are also asking you average velocity between t is equal to 2 seconds and t is equal to 4 seconds. Understood or not? Yes or no? Okay, so let us solve it. As this is first question, we will do it together. Okay. So, they are saying this is the profile of the motion. This is also called as equation of a motion or profile of a motion. We know what we know. If x is f of t, then v instantaneous is given by dx by dt. Okay, now x is equal to what here? A plus vt square. So what will be dx by dt? What is derivative of constant? Zero plus 2bt. Okay, so instantaneous velocity equation will be 2bt. I will call this equation of x as equation 1, this equation as 2. Okay, now the initial requirement has been satisfied. So the next thing what they are asking me is, at t is equal to 0 second, at t is equal to 0 second, what is instantaneous velocity? We know v instantaneous is equal to 2bt. So substitute, t is equal to 0. So v instantaneous at 2 is equal to 0 is, t is equal to 0 is 2b into 0. How much is that? 0 meter per second. Can you tell me what is instantaneous velocity at t is equal to 2 second? So again, same formula, v instantaneous is how much? 2bt. So 2 into b into 2. But what is b value? 2.5. So v instantaneous at t is equal to 2 second is 2 into 2.5 into 2. How much is that? 10 meter per second. So understood how to find out instantaneous velocity? Yes or no?
Yes,
sir. So if you didn't know how to take a derivative of a function, can you find out what is instantaneous velocity? When you follow a state board syllabus, unfortunately, that is what happens. You come to know about derivative only by, you know, at the end of your 11th class. But still, you have to find out what is instantaneous velocity. So God knows how you can find out. Is there any other way? There is no other way. You have to learn derivative in order to find instantaneous velocity. There is one more method, a graphical method. Then plot a graph of x versus t. Okay. And keep on doing one problem for one day. Next. Now we have to find out what? Color of this? What is next thing? Average velocity. Now we know v average is equal to x2 minus x1 divided by t2 minus t1. Average velocity has to be calculated between two points, t1 and t2. Here t1 is given as 2 second, t2 is given as 4 second. They are asking between 2 to 4 second, right? Can you give me x1 value and x2 value? For x1 substitute, this is the equation, see. For x1 substitute, t is equal to 2. And for x2 substitute, t is equal to 4 second. A and b values are known to you. So x1 is equal to 8.5 plus 2.5 into 2 square. So 10 plus 8.5, it is 18.5 meter. And x2 will be 8.5 plus 2.5 into 4 square, that is 16. 16 into 2.5, how much? 40 plus 8.5, 48.5 meter. Now you know x2, you know t2, you know x1, you know t1. Tell me what is average velocity? 48.5 minus 18.5 divided by 4 minus 2. So 30 by 2, that is 15 meter per second. Yes or no? Can you tell me what is instantaneous velocity at 4 second? Instantaneous velocity at 4 second. You have calculated at 0 and 2 second. Can you tell me at 4 second? What is the relation you have to use? 2bt. Yes or no? See, today evening you will get set of around 10 questions based on average and instantaneous velocity. That you have to solve and come tomorrow. Okay? Tell me, what is velocity at 4 seconds? How much? 80? 20 meter per second. And what was velocity at 2 seconds? 2 seconds? 10. So can you tell me this motion is uniform acceleration motion or not? How to find it out? Yes, Lambert, tell me. Double differentiation will give you acceleration. I agree. Without finding acceleration, you can do it. If you have heard my lecture, this lecture properly. For constant acceleration motion, average velocity is v1 plus v2 by 2. You have found average velocity, which is 15. You know what is v1 and v2. At t2 or at 2 seconds, it is 15, right? How much it was? 10. At 2 seconds, it was 10. And at 4 seconds, it was 20. 10 plus 20 by 2 is 15. So if average velocity is v1 plus v2 by 2, will it be uniform acceleration motion? Yes or no?
Yes.
So only smart kids are listening lectures very, very carefully. Because this lecture is not only for NEET level, CET level, mains level, advanced level, all the exams you can crack. Okay, so you have to utilize the experience of the faculty. If you are at CET level, you will feel lecture is also at CET level. If you are at GE advanced level, you will also feel lecture is at GE advanced level. Meanwhile, we would like to announce, yesterday we got one more update of our result. We have circulated, hope you have seen those results. We have updated our results. GE main paper 2, how many of you know GE main paper 2? GE main paper 1 is given for BTech, admission for BE or BTech courses. Okay. Paper 2 is given for admission for BArch, Bachelor of Architecture, which is a 5-year course. Okay. So around 5 to 6 NITs and 2 IITs are offering architecture course. So competition is huge. And that exam is also, you can say, equally tough as that of JEE Main 1. 75 mark exam, right? 300 marks. I told you topper of JEE Main paper 1 from Perfect Academy this year is 99%. Topper of JEE Main paper 2, yesterday we got updates from our result. His name is C. Lanston Daniel. He's from Corpus Christi School, Tamil Nadu. And he scored 99.05% marks. And he is the regional topper there in JE main paper 2 for architecture. So if you are willing to become BE, BTech engineer or even architecture, Perfect Academy can shape your future provided you work hard. If you behave like ordinary student, sitting in classes, enjoying the show as if you are watching Kapil Sharma show, writing in notebook, going and keeping your notebook down and sleeping, that won't work out. If you are coming here, keep your dreams higher and try to accelerate your performance on daily basis. Every day is exam for you. Work harder than yesterday.